You know, one of the great joys of playing this game when it's, you know, a pre-release version of the game, which I'm going to be honest, I didn't do much of when it was the Shadow and the Blade, when it was Malice and Snitch, or whatever the fuck, because I don't much care for the Skaven or the Dark Elves, to be honest. Still not completed the campaign as the Skaven, only recently did as the Dark Elves. But one of the great joys of that is that I get to see a lot of bugs that I don't normally actually run into, including the rampant T-posing of agents on the battlefield, where they just kind of stood over their horses. Most of them are doing it in my Greenskins campaign, Immortal Empires, at this point. It's wild. Alright, in fact, actually, I was going to tell you about a different bug that happened in just the live version of the game, but I'll tell you that in a moment. I want to do my introduction. Alright, dickheads, I'm your chunky messiah, Ethan, and I'm just here with some more of this here Total War Warhammer 2 on that there PC. Grom the Paunch, the Grim and the Grave, not the Grim and the Grave, the Grim and the Grom, the Warden and the Paunch. There we go. It just occurred to me, I'm pretty sure that by the time you've watched this, by the time this goes up, this is going to be after the DLC is released. And in fact, actually, there was a patch released for the build that I'm playing just today. Today being the 18th, but I believe that the bugs I just mentioned probably will have been ironed out by the time we get to the final release, or at least eased. One of the wildest bugs I've ever gotten, actually, in Total War, Warhammer, was while I was waiting for just around the time that this DLC was first announced, I started a Dark Elf campaign. It was actually shortly after I'd completed the recording, although it's not all up yet, obviously. Shortly after I'd completed the recording of Worship Grom. Let's just head in this direction here. It was shortly after I'd completed the recording of Ark and the Black, in fact. I decided to do a Vortex campaign with the Dark Elves, because I hadn't done one yet. I completed it in relatively short order. But the wild thing that happened was at one point, I think during the last, like, wave of chaos that comes after you when you're completing the final ritual, I auto-resolved a fight, and it was with multiple armies, basically I think it was like three of my armies against three chaos armies. I auto-resolved it because I was just trying to basically force my way through the arse end of the campaign, because I just wanted it done, because it always happens to me with Vortex campaigns. I get incredibly sick of trying to maintain my territory and just start trying to force it through if I feel like the game is nearly done. And Malekith died. He just gone forever. He died. And my army leader ended up being, my faction leader ended up being some random Dark Elf. Sorceress was my faction leader with Malekith's, like, diplomacy lines. It was really strange. I don't know how that happened. But yeah, that did happen. Wild. Okay, so we're just kind of continuing our fight against the lizard men here. It is kind of, like, striking to me how remarkably little, how remarkably, really, they call them deskinnies, alright, how remarkably little, not progress, but kind of money we've got at the moment. I don't know why it surprised me, the Greenskins don't have the best economy in the world. I've been playing my own campaign. In fact, if I load up here, I should be able to show you where I am here, the biggest war. Turn 117, taken all this territory. I've actually confederated everyone except for Grom, because Grom, unfortunately, was wiped out before I could get to him. I'm currently attempting to basically bait the game into summoning a rebellion of him to take over the territory so I can beat up his reincarnated faction and then confederate him so I have all of the greenskin leaders before I go to war with the Empire. Before I start that in earnest. But, for like a good solid while in that campaign, I've had not reinforcements, I've not had any income This has been in the red. My predicted income's been in the red. But I've managed to sustain it just because I've been sacking and fighting people so often that I'm basically drowning in money. So that even though I've got like negative 1,000 gold per turn, I'm able to come to the other side of it. It's almost like the Greenskins have the economy, or have a similar economy to Norska, or just Horde factions, despite having a territory of their own. Like, despite having, being able to, inhabit all kinds of areas, instead of, like, the Norska approach of only being able to get a certain few. The Golden Tower, it looks like I might have left that too long, and the Golden Tower is, in a nicer spot here. But we shall see. See if we can't wipe out the Golden Tower on our way back to getting Grom into our own territory for his replenishment there.
Orc Slayer.
I am thinking, actually, part of the reason why I might have had an easier time, specifically with my economy, playing as Grimgor in Mortal Empires, is just because Grimgor is surrounded by greenskin races, and that ability to basically bonk a guy over the head and steal all of his people is let's get the chariot races. There we are, because I want to also rebuild his army here with some of the new units we've got access to. But the ability to basically bonk a guy over the head and steal his faction does wonders for your economy, believe it or not. Yeah, let's get Aspect of the Dread Knight. You're already immortal. I can't remember if I gave you that or if you started with it. No, I think I gave you that, didn't I? Okay, let's just start making her a bit more of a bit of a tougher melee proposition. And let's just waste some money on that there.
Orcs will.
Okay, we did actually successfully block him. Do you have Assassinate? Yeah, you have Assassinate. Let's get a Specialist there. I don't necessarily want to go to war with Khemri at the moment. Although, that having been said, I could go to war with them, to be fair. Because they're not too big. What's this army here got in it? Oh yeah, I'm definitely going to war with you, actually. But let's call a war here. And oh, I think by doing that, if we successfully, where's Khemri? It's there. Okay, if we succeed in this war, we might actually legitimately be able to go from a big trophy to the biggest trophy, which would be quite a nice one. What do we actually get for going against you? Increased speed, increased winds of magic, and increased income from post-battle loot. Oh, all right. And yeah, let's go with Mork there as ever.
Time to fight.
And let's see if we can't beat up Setra the Imperishable. I'm gonna give the settlement AI control, but I will control our own war force here. I think we can do this. I mean, again, the only really scary unit we've got to worry about is the Khemrian War Sphinx, which we, actually looking at it, have no answer to. Hang on a sec. I've got a bunch of scrap. What's my current ability? Enables sundering attacks on Grom, Berserk, Dragon Breath. Does explosive damage. Yep, that's all fine. It's the lack of... Okay, reinforced weapons. That won't help. That's not going to help much either. Yeah, it looks like we don't actually have anything that can help that one. Let's have a look in here. Do we have something that'll help us against large things? Damn it. We could have if we had that winged leather or whatever it was. Leather, like wing leather. Shit. Ah, well.
The whole world's gonna be drums.
Ah, well, let's hope it goes well. And actually, Khemri would be a very nice place to get, because that's got a gold mine. And even the greenskins, again, a big reason why their economy is a lot weaker than a lot of the other economies in the game, is just purely off the back of, partially because they have no trade, but then also largely because they have no, they don't have, the buildings that take advantage of resources don't give them money. They give them upkeep reductions and some kind of rank increases, faction-wide, but yeah, it doesn't give them any extra cash, which is one of the reasons why they're a bit weak. But even the greenskins, who don't really do that, even the greenskins are able to take advantage of a gold mine. Because, you know, it's full of shinies, they understand that. Okay, here we go. I'll tell you this for an absolute fact. Playing as Grom over here is doing wonders for giving me variety in the factions I'm fighting, because I spent the first 70 turns as Grimgar's in Grimgar's campaign just fighting dwarves and occasionally orcs. First 10 turns as all orcs, then I confederated Wurzag, and most of the other orcs had basically already been wiped out by the dwarves, and then I spent the next like 50 turns fighting dwarves. Wiped them out though. The main dwarf faction, which had by that point actually confederated all of the... I was just going to say all, but it was nowhere near all. It confederated, Belagar. But Ungrim Ironfist was still where he is, actually. Still hanging out near vampire territory. Hasn't really gone anywhere. Okay. Now, I'm hoping... So I'm yawning then. What the... Oh, there's like a very slight hill. Alright. I'm hoping that, I'll be able to... take advantage of these running lads to try to harass the Khemrian War Sphinx into fucking itself up, essentially. Where is the War Sphinx? Where are you? There you are, big lad. Hoping to do some damage with the skirmish cav here. What speed does that guy move at? 76. Okay, good. All of my missile cav is just faster than that. That's good. And that's one reinforcement army. And that's the other. And this is the other reinforcement army. Let's just rush them forward. If these guys get messed up, if the war armies get messed up, I really don't care all that much. I'm totally fine with them getting colossally ruined. It's just my only real concern for the safety of my armies is the big import is the main lads. I never really care about the smaller ones. Okay, let's summon you there. And let's charge you forward. Let's see how that goes. Yeah, just gonna send the spiders out around to try and get that Screaming Skull catapult in the back there. Okay, well, the War Sphinx is being damaged. It has taken some damage. Not much, it is true, but some damage is better than none, you know what I mean? Okay. I'm actually going to be a cheeky bugger and bafflingly send my goblins to go fight the Khemrian War Sphinx while I try to send Yeah, well, I try to order the orcs into a somewhat more direct battle. Actually, that's a point. Send those lads out after the Khemrian War Sphinx, actually. And let's just... Where are we having some trouble? We're having some trouble over there. So let's just try and... buff these lads up as best we can. And indeed, cast another spell there. What's going on over here? You're a bit far away for me to cast in the Khemrian War Sphinx there, I'm afraid. Where the fuck is... Yeah, you know what, Cetra. You just keep doing you. You're doing fine.
Come on! Happy to help! Fast.
And let's just set those spiders to go have their fight over there.
Wait.
Lovely.
Let's get them. Come on then.
That's about right to me. And actually, yeah, let's send these orc boys in here to try and reinforce that situation. Hi guys, how it goes? Get a bit of a war going. Oh god, where are the Ushabti?
Let's get stabbing.
Not the worst position to spawn into, I suppose. I'm still hoping that at some point someone will be able to explain to me what it is that causes the weird slowdown I get quite a lot. That doesn't actually affect the frame rate, but it changes the animation speed, the animation frame rate of all of the, all my units while the actual game runs at the same speed. I don't quite understand why that happens. At a guess, I'd say it's my CPU being weird. There's a lot of things that, can be boiled down, its cause can be boiled down to my Ethan's CPU has been being weird. Okay, so it looks like the armor sundering arrows are pretty much doing the job on that one there.
This is it.
Found it. Me is better than them. Shut up. No stabbing.
Bad boys. Bad boys.
Oh, God.
And, oh, a second war. Don't mind if I do. Oh, Khemrian War Sphinx is dead. Okay. Everyone turn around and harass the archers. Or the archer chariots, rather. Just a fantastic looking fight there.
Kill him. Come on, lads.
Let's get him.
I think this is basically it for Cetra's army here, isn't it? This is the be all and end all of it. Now that the War Sphinx is gone, it's just him and these lads, and they've just all collapsed. So, at a guess, I'm going to say. Is he crumbling over here? If he is crumbling, he's taking his sweet fucking time about it. I mean, the rest of his entire force has crumbled, so... One would assume that he also went. Yeah, he is crumbling. It is just taking him a while. It's taking him a while to realize that he's died. Just cast some spells to try and inform him. There we go. They didn't actually need to cast the spells to inform him there. He worked it out on his own. He got there eventually. But yeah, that that Khemrian War Sphinx did mess us up quite badly. Did mess us up quite badly. I do keep underestimating how much of a threat individual melee lords can be, however. On the plus side, did my main army actually take much damage? Not really. I mean, there's a couple of units that got a bit of a beating, but yeah. The main army didn't actually take that much damage. Actually, that felt like we took a lot more damage than we did, looking at the numbers. Okay. I mean, again, they did that to themselves, to be honest. But honestly, that fight went fine. Fight went fine. I need to remember that when I actually, like, play these fights out, I don't do too badly.
The tribe's ready!
I swear to God, that's like what so much of me losing in big fights are. It's not actually because the fight's impossible. Not even necessarily that I'm inherently bad at the game. It's just I half the time I just don't take any leading risks.
Under Grom's whales.
Let's try out the Golden Tower again and raise it to the ground. Cool. And if I recall correctly, I think that this might actually be the place that the lizard men, that the last defenders actually start on. So we basically just burnt down their home territory, which, I don't know about you, but I'm quite pleased about that. I'm rather comfortable in that situation. And, ooh, yes, please. Let's upgrade that, because then we're going to be able to get ourselves rogue idols in relatively short order, which is always a good thing. The rogue idols, I can't wait to actually be able to use the rogue idols properly in this series, because the rogue idols are just incredibly fun. They are just such good fun.
Mork says what?
Let's send this guy forward. Go ourselves a bit of a scout. What have we got here? I'm trying to think, what do? We attack Khemri, or do we try and take the salt plane?
Nasty magic ready.
Because I'm not gonna lie, I'm thinking we are just gonna conquer kinda this section and also take Khemri. And then go back to just kind of burning everything.
Me.
Purely off the back of the gold mine. If we're gonna have Khemri, we might as well have the province, you know what I mean? Plus, actually, there's not that many places that are just kind of ideally set up for greenskins, so we are gonna just, if we're gonna have any territory, we are gonna have to be inhabiting jungles, inhabiting unpleasant climates, somewhat.
Into the rocks.
Because otherwise, we're just not gonna have anything.
Who should we tap?
My faith in you.
Okay, that's their other army. Okay, well, let's just pull out here and raid them and basically see if we can't bait them into attacking us again. It should be a nice one if we could bait them into an attack there. And also, yeah, great. Gorgazan there while we wait. Hero not moved. How much territory do you guys actually control? That's a big question. 6. Okay, so that's 1, 2, 3. There's another one in here, Zandri, that's there for 4.
The tribe's ready.
So I need to figure out where the other territory these guys control is. It's not the Black Pyramid of Nagash, which, by the way, I'm going to be leaving thoroughly well enough alone. My assumption is that it's probably on the coast, which we're going to be wanting to sack and raid. More than anything else.
This is my land.
Oh, yeah. Keep forgetting about that. Yeah, for some reason, the Wah... you get notifications about the Wah army as if it's a separate army, which always... whenever there's raiding anywhere near you that your Wah army is in some way involved with, it's an odd one.
World's gonna be crumbs.
I don't quite understand it. Let's go wild. I just keep increasing her ability in to handle herself in a proper fight, though. Okay, what else do we need to build in here? Oop, give me just a moment. Ah, fuck, I hit the wrong button. Ah, well. Lara just fucking needed my attention for something because her Discord broke. And I hit fucking end recording instead of pause recording. Ah, well, that's a good place as any to end the video. That's going to be all for me for now. Bye. Well, I hope you enjoyed that. I might not have, but then that's kind of irrelevant. I'd make the stuff, not watch it. Anyway, big thanks to the names that are and have been scrolling across the screen. Their donations to my Patreon campaign are a huge help to me and the channel. If you'd also like to have your name listed here, follow the link in the description to find my Patreon page. There are rewards and such. Down there you'll also find links to my Twitter, Twitch, and the channel's Discord server. Stuff often occurs in one or indeed all of those places, so go have a look. And if you want more content, I upload basically a video a day. Right, I'm out of time. Bye.